Essentially, the script writing and telling the story, I was just engaged with script labs, but I kind of just financed it by working freelance. And then when the script is ready, I approached financiers. Because in India, it works very differently. We don't get soft funding for films at all. So I really don't have a choice. And then if I had a French co-producer, and luckily we didn't find the development funding. We tried a lot. I didn't give up, and I did it myself. Having done that in the first film out of desperation, I would continue doing that in my next film, because that's where you earn your freedom. And after that, it's like, take it or don't take it kind of a thing. I mean, I figured that out for myself, that that would give me the freedom. Sometimes you do find producers who love and agree with everything that you make, but you can never be sure about it.
With my film, it wasn't necessarily like a gender problem at all. I don't know if that was kind of your question, but...
Gender or just reality of trying to get your film done, really?
Yeah, mine... I made mine in quite a specific way, in that it was a scheme that's run by the BFI, the BBC and Creative England, called iFeatures. So they pick 12 teams off a treatment, and then you develop it together, and they finance 3 films at the end. So we didn't have to like go out to finance, because we were one of the lucky films that got funded. But the only kind of problems I had further down the line was that my film is a kind of hybrid of genres. So it's part a coming-of-age tale, and part there's sort of elements of horror, a bit of body horror, some thriller language within the film. So that the fact that I was trying to mix these genres was kind of often a question through the development process and into shooting and through the edit as well, of whether that was going to succeed in a way that meant the film could be seen. I guess that's what I'm sort of seeing now, is like how we're marketing the film to an audience, and what kind of, you know, if we try and sell it as a horror, a lot of the audience is going to be very disappointed, I think, because it's not that. So I think those are the problems I've found that I guess are to do with, and we've been lucky that we've got Curzon are distributing our film, so they've sort of taken us on and are excited, I think, about the challenges that it poses. But yeah, that was, for me specifically, that was our problem.
So the film has been financed by the public fundings in Belgium, France. It's co-production, so the French-speaking part and the Flemish treatment also of Belgium, and French TV and Belgian TV. And so I think, yeah, I was quite lucky finding the fundings and not waiting too much. But the issue was more like it's happening in the Philippines. So how we are, comment ça nous concerne, à quel point ça nous concerne?
The way in which it concerns us.
Yeah, and so it was a matter of telling, okay, it's happening in the Philippines, but the person who are hiring these domestic workers are abroad, overseas, and we are all concerned in a way, because, you know, European population is also aging a lot, and all these foreign women, you know, are working here, and they're helping, you know, like taking care of the kids and also the elderly. And so and there is one Belgian documentary film that has been made like 10 years ago, so it's quite a long time ago, that was talking about Indonesia, a kind of training center that's a bit the same than in the Philippines. And for Belgian TV, they wouldn't be interested by the movie, because they would tell, like, oh, it already has been told. And we're a bit struck by that, because, I mean, Indonesia is not the Philippines, but it was as if it was just the same. And also, you know, I'm not making a film only because of the subject, but it's the way the subject is traité,
told
that is interesting. And actually, both of the movie are very different, but I really had difficulties to get this funding in Belgium, the public one. So it's only the third time that I got it. But unless, like, although in France, nobody asked me about this film, but because it was a Belgian filmmaker, then it was difficult. So sometimes, you don't know why, but people stick to some idea, and then it's difficult to make them understand, you know, your intention. And I have noticed that once we did at the end of finance, the fact that we did a trailer really helped, like convincing TVs, and that's a bit tricky because you're making a documentary and you have to write like amount of pages of scenario, you know, the script, even if it's a documentary. And so it's like you have to have money beforehand the shooting to prove that you know, you're going to do a film in that or that way. So it is a bit difficult, I think. When you hear the people who were making film before, like you had only like 5 pages of you know, intentions, and that was it. And now I have the impression that you have to prove, you know, like by writing. And I have the feeling that writing and making a film is so different. So that's a bit difficult.